lot of drip. Money calling back to back, so I keep taking trips. Spend a couple mil, just on one crib. Hold up, let me crack the seal, take another sip. Whole lot of drip, whole lot of drip.
CC Gang Jester M16 back with another video, man. As you can see, guys, I finally made my way to Five Guys. I don't know if y'all can see this, but in the bag, they gave me a whole lot. I asked for the small fry, and this is what I got. Fries on top of the burger, fries in the cup, fries under the bag. The bag got grease on it. I like that because, like, when I eat at Chick-fil-A and ask for the large fry, I drive out eating. So on the way, you know, by the time I get to the house, it's already gone. And I ordered a small caramel milkshake, or not caramel, salted caramel milkshake. I didn't know what kind of what to expect from Five Guys, but you know, this is where I went with. Honestly, between these fries and this milkshake, I'm already about full. And as for the burger, literally gotta fight with fries just to get my burger. I got the two patties with the double cheeseburger. Yeah, man.
I'm assuming the bacon's in there somewhere, but yeah, that's what I ordered.
I'm telling you right now, I can already tell between all this food, it's probably gonna last me the rest of the day. It's funny though, because when I walked in there, I told the lady this is my first time coming. She looked at me like, what'd that mean? For some reason, this is my first time going to Five Guys today, but for some reason, I always believed that Five Guys sold pizza, but I went in there today. Potatoes in front, you know, for the line. They actually had to go out and grab the potatoes to make the actual fries. You know, they actually like pretty much handmade everything, not just, you know, process it. Really good. I can see me going back. Since I got y'all, I got a mini story time about the time I drunk chocolate milk. That's the only thing I had the whole day. And I almost didn't make it to the house, you know, because I had to, you know, I had to go. I don't know why I didn't eat breakfast that morning, but I think it's because I had something big the night before. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. My burger about gone, but there's still so many fries still left. And there's still some milkshake left, and this is small. So I left the house around like at least like 8:30, like around 9 something. But I had to run a couple errands around the city. I had to go see my mom that day. I had to see my grandma. I had to go to the store. By the time I got to the store, my grandma said she needed stuff from the store. So my grocery shopping turned into her grocery shopping too. By the time I actually had got to my grandma's house, I was around like at least going on 11 because I was stuck at, I think I went to Publix that day. So I was stuck at Publix for a little minute. It was packed. And I had a chance to spare myself because my grandma, when I got to the house, my grandma was cooking. She said, you want something to eat? I said, nope. I was fine because, you know, chocolate fills you up. It fills me up. I don't know about everybody else, but it fills me up for the time being. So I was fine. So I ended up putting her groceries up and I was sitting and talking to her about like at least an hour and a half, 2 hours. Went to my mom's house, and on the way there, I ended up stopping to get her something, like a drink and some chips. And I still had a chance to still kind of get me some fast food. Declined it because I was still feeling full. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I'm kind of already full and I still kind of got like a ways to go. My burgers are obviously decimated. My fries are still present. And I still kind of got a little bit of that shake left. I don't think I can eat no more. I'm gonna give it a minute to let the food settle, then we'll continue my Five Guys journey. So when I finally did get to my mom's house, I think it was going on around like 1 o'clock. She wasn't cooking, but she had snacks that could have filled me up to avoid the situation. I declined it. Like I said, I was feeling full. I didn't really feel like eating that much. So I sat with her for a couple hours and chilled. And then when I finally did leave, got my car. I always remember this time because somebody had called me. And my phone's already hooked up to the Bluetooth. So automatically I can look at the time right there. It was like 4:13 p.m. I backed out, drive, get ready to get back on interstate. I'm already in traffic. You know, traffic is live right now. It's around 4 o'clock, getting ready to be 5. So Tampa traffic is ridiculous at this time. Get on the interstate. Still feeling fine. I'm already thinking about getting my meal because I haven't ate, you know, since this morning. So, or, you know, the only thing I had was that chocolate milk. Now, out of nowhere, something just grabbed my stomach. And this wasn't your normal feeling of having to go to the restroom. This just was like a, ooh, like, I'm not going to make it. And I felt kind of sick. Now, mind you, traffic is already horrible. I'm not thinking straight. I don't know what to do. It's already been 5 minutes. It's just feeling, and it just won't go away. I'm thinking about pulling over. I'm having regrets of not eating from my grandma. I'm having flashbacks.
I got a burning in my stomach. Oh, my stomach hurts. Oh, man. Oh, please.
Oh, and me, normally, I refuse to use public bathrooms. I don't want to do that because at this time, I'm like, I can't make it. I can't feel like I'm going to make it. So I'm thinking about getting a cup, a bottle or something because I cannot make it.
gas station over there? Oh, here we go. Yeah, that's the gas station.
I was about to say, forget all that. I'm just going to pull on the side of the road and do it later. But then something in my head clicked that said, I'm not going to be on Florida Man, you know, front cover Florida Man, you know, on the side of the road, using the bathroom. Pain wouldn't go away. It still was keeping up. I'm just cutting lanes. I'm speeding. I'm trying to get on the emergency side of the road, but I'm like, I can't do that. I'm just trying to get to somewhere. I don't even know where I'm going as fast as possible. Finally, after what felt like forever, the pain started easing up in my stomach. I still had that knot sitting right in the middle of my stomach. I was holding the wind, because if I let go, all the probably just came out. But pain didn't start easing finally. I started to be able to think rationally. Blood was running to my head. I ended up thinking maybe I can make it to a convenience store, uppity convenience store, use the bathroom really quick, and then dip. But I was thinking, I don't like using public bathrooms again. So I was like, maybe I can make it to my granddad's house, which was, I was coming up on it. No, it's not that far. So I called my granddad in advance, probably about 10 minutes in advance, tell him, please have the bathroom ready for me because I have an emergency right now. I'm hot. Coming in hot right now. Felt like they were trying to keep me on the interstate and not let me get to this exit, but I was able to maneuver through them, get off on the exit, still speeding. I ended up taking all back roads to get to my granddad's house, skirted onto the street, and I'm pulling there. He was already sitting outside. Said, what's up? Well, ran right past him. My stomach still had that knot holding strong, and I had to keep holding what was inside. So, because I felt like if I let go or start relaxing, everything was just going to come out. I basically tackled the door to get there. So I finally got to, you know, my seat and let all the unwanted bodily fluids out. And I promised myself I will never do that again. I'll make sure I eat something and make sure if I have to make myself eat something, or if I only had chocolate milk that day. But that pretty much runs out of mini story time, guys. I had already threw away the little Five Guys bag. I ate all the food. I'm full, but I'm not full. I feel like I can eat again in a couple hours, but it did fill me up. That was a lot of food, mostly fries. It was a little greasy. The bag was greasy. But I can see me going there again probably like another week or so, because that's a lot of food we'd be trying to eat daily. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and notification bell down below. I'll check you guys in the next video, man.
Can't calm down, bitch, I'm too turned up. Judge don't give me love.